Can I see you?
I forgot. I legit forgot that you can look. I don't fucking know what's going
weird
on.
Weird ass motherfucker.
Look, I'm not Jeremy. I'm not high. All right?
Stop doing shrooms before.
I don't do shrooms.
You don't have people sending you fucking messages. Saying,
that's why I'm saying this right now. I do not do any drugs. I'm just not normal.
Now they think you're a nerd.
Fuck it. All right, you're just gonna think I'm a nerd. Fuck you guys.
All right. So today, Beer Bongs and Bentleys came out. Post Malone's new album. We already listened to Spoil My Night and everything, so we pretty much just want to get right into this, listen to Paranoid. Also doesn't say who produced this, and I don't know if he produces his own songs or not at all, actually. So, see how this sounds. You know, it's funny. I know this is the beginning of the album, and a lot of people like to try to start it soft sometimes, but this kind of goes with exactly what I was saying last video, or the second video for this song. Second song for this album. And that, I'm like, sometimes you don't know whether to classify Post Malone as a singer or an actual rapper. I mean, I like that he does both, but you know.
Not only that, I like how this song and the last song we listened to is kind of upbeat, but a smooth hip-hop type of vibe.
At the same time, too, you kind of also wonder, was he going to be pretty serious in this album? But I think the last couple of lyrics answered that for me.
No, yeah, this song sounds like it would be on one of those MTV reality shows.
Yeah, I can see that.
With fucking, what's that one show that's on there with the dating and your exes on there?
Oh, yeah.
The fucking cliche ass.
I'm not sure if that's one of the challenges or what the fuck that is. Not gonna lie, I did not expect him. I know I always started with not gonna lie, but hey, I'm not lying.
at least you know you're a trustworthy person.
I'm like, I didn't think he'd actually get pretty political on this, like, quite literally, I guess, in that one. But I'm like, I fuck with it.
Also, I don't know how the fuck he does that little voice jump thing. I can't even fucking do it.
Never do that again.
I regret life.
That hurt my ears. This song, the last song, I mean, it's pretty big. I know they say first impressions are everything, but I guess that's the same thing for albums. And I feel like if somebody had not really heard Post Malone, like, you know how certain artists are kind of hard to get into?
Yeah.
You don't know what songs to listen to? It seems like he's very all-around, I guess you say versatile in this case, you know? And I'm like, damn, we said that a lot. Yeah, we said that a lot as well, but it's just that's just how a lot of the artists we've been listening to have been landing or whatever.
Yeah.
But I'm trying not to say I fuck with this. Because I just said that, but I'm like, I could see myself listening to this a lot, you know, even if this is about, like, his problems before, up to
really
now.
It's something you can chill to. I know I say that, like, I sound like a high nigga constantly when I say that, but...
Some people try to say, you know, when it comes to Post Malone as well, I've also heard a couple times, it was just, like, more of a party thing at the same time.
Yeah.
And I was like, a lot of times he does sing about his problems as, you know... and this is something I guess a lot of people, different people can relate to in terms of the...
He's a human.
Paranoid and, you know, trying to get some relief
from
a lot of the problems people have been having.
Yeah, the title basically tells you what he's
especially
been saying.
Especially as far as politics goes, I think we can all agree on that one.
Of course.
That's a pretty intense way to start the album, I'd say.
Especially in terms of being meaningful. That sounds like a feels type song, too.
Yeah. I'm like, it can be, I guess you could kind of say it could be kind of relaxing at the same time.
Yeah.
But, you know, it you could tell that that song kind of meant a lot to him in that one. I know people would love seeing that one actually perform live.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, again, tell us who produced it if you actually know it. I actually been feeling this album pretty...
I fucks with it. As you say.
Put that on a fucking shirt. Fucking motto for us. You know, and you already know the album starts with Paranoid, then goes Spoil My Night, then everyone's already heard Rockstar, Psycho, and Candy Paint for some people or whatever. Yeah. We're gonna do more of these songs and everything. Tell us what else you actually want to see reaction to. Oh, wait. Don't forget to subscribe.
But wait.
It's kind of tough for me to actually say that. And, you know, Zayd and everybody always fucking screaming if I don't say. We got the website, mobflips.com. Got boards and Dago.
See, you fucked up already. You didn't say skate shit.
Fuck that.
Skate shit.
Mobflips.com. We got fucking, you know, decks, grip tape, wheels. You know, we got the Instagrams down below. So follow us on that. I don't know what the fuck just made that notification. I don't know if there's even a device over there. But yeah, so we'll see you guys next time. It's been Brandon from Mob Flips, and he been Justin from Mob Flips. That's right, I said he been. Nobody loves him.
I don't know if I was somebody else before, but okay.
He been.
I don't fucking trust Alexa.
We could call you a fucking has-been.
No,
exactly. Alexa listening to every damn conversation we having.
I hear you, NSA.
Fucking with that Post Malone album, huh, nigga?
Wait, what the fuck did you just say?
Saying what if Alexa had said that? You fuck with that Post Malone album, huh, nigga?
Oh, I thought you was asking me.
Like, Alexa, I don't know if that was racist or not, but
exactly. I don't even know if you're...
I like it.
Are you legally able to say that, Alexa?
It's a robot, dog.
Yeah, but robots have rights. You know what their rights are? Nothing.
That's where I'm going to stop
the
video.
Wait, do not stop. Pause.
Your whole life is a pause moment.
He's just hating.
But,
you
know,
so who do you think they're going to draft, Zay?
I want them to either get... Damn, nigga, why are you so close? They either going to get DJ Moore or Calvin Ridley. Those are my only two options.
I like Christian Kirk and DJ Moore.
Anthony Miller, if he's sitting there, might as well take him because he's really good at catching.
Pause yourself. Okay, pause. What was his name?
Anthony.
Nigga can't say Anthony.
Anthony. No, shit, I said it the first time. Anthony.
Oh, no, you said it exactly how you fucked what, up. You like Anthony Miller. Oh, I was like, what? Brandon.
Oh, God.
Viet Tim Nee.
Oh, yeah, Viet Tim
Nee. My sick ass angles.
You notice the camera's recorded from like hella high compared to how it was before. Like, what are you like? Had to count on my fingers real fast.
Well, what the fuck are you doing?
7 inches tall.
Elementary school.
6.5.
Yo, this is a clear ass view. What side of you got this on?
I got this on everything. As in, you can see everything. You can see our pores. You can see recent chicken grease on the side of my face that ain't there because I'm black. I'm a stereotype, but I ain't a stereotype, dog. You see what I'm saying?
So, what'd you have for dinner?
Chicken.
We all had chicken. See, now you had the wings. I just had chicken in a sub.
Listen, chicken is chicken. It's close enough. They're like, oh, look, we're pulling up to the blackest house in the neighborhood real fast. You know they got to order chicken real fast. Yeah!
Oh, man, God damn.
Talking
about
me?
They don't need to see in here, though.
The day in the life of a YouTuber. You said they don't need to see?
Nah, man. This is the secret. It's backstage. Extra access. See what I'm saying? They're like, what's in that room? You don't know what's in that room. You never gonna know what's in that room. It's a bunch of shit.
This could have been a start of a good music video while you walking out.
He like goes to the side and I come in. Hey, I ain't Marcus. I didn't have to find myself in California.
Well, shots. We should really do a reenact. We should really reenact Skip and Shannon.
Bro, what is that going to do for us?
It's like, what do you mean? What is it gonna do, dog? We could tag Shannon in it since you know he gonna look at it, dog. If we tag him in it, he might look at it and they gonna put it on Undisputed.
What if he looked at it and he responded was like, if I ever see y'all in person, I'm fucking y'all up.
Damn. Like, shit, man, we're Ravens fans. Like, I'd figure you'd appreciate us, bro. Like, we're fellow Baltimoreans. Even though you're not originally from Baltimore, I mean, you played for two years.
Yeah, you got a ring with us.
You got carried by the defense, but, you know, it's whatever.
The greatest defense of all time, 2000 Ravens.
Damn right they are.
Stats better than the 85 Bears.
Just finish. I said finish.
Shit, I'm going to speed right now. Look, it's like 1 o'clock in the morning. I don't blame you.
Just finish.
So,
do I look like